Whenever you're in placing this cache and you're digging this out, what you need to do first is, with a shovel, especially this is useful, is I'll go around and I'll use that shovel to cut kind of a plug so that I maintain the grass and the vegetation. It's still alive, the roots are still fairly intact. So, and then from there, all the dirt that I remove from this, I also place on a poncho. My goal is to not put a lot of displacement in this area. And I don't want, you know, I don't want a lot of bare dirt showing when I leave this place. I want this to grow back to be as natural looking as possible as soon as possible. So when I'm removing dirt from here, I'm placing it on a poncho along with the grass plug that's on top of it. Or if you're doing it in the wood line, the leaf litter on top, you want to put it back as best you can. Once I've got this dug and I've got all my contents set aside to where they're not going to be all over the place, I'm going to emplace my cache. And this particular cache is a DIY that's made out of PVC pipe. Understand that this is the durable container that's on the outside that protects it from the elements, keeps it from getting crushed from the weight of the dirt. And everything inside here is also vacuum sealed. And then on both ends, I put an oxygen absorber or a desiccant. It depends on what you have in here. Anything that's in here that's corrodible, I'll coat that with some sort of a heavy oil before I put it in there, just to kind of prevent that corrosion in the event this leaks. But these ends, I have the threads sealed. So when I come back out to service it, you know, of course, I'm gonna bring the wrench to open these. I'm gonna basically pop both ends off, take the oxygen absorbers out, look at the contents inside if there's something that's corrodible, change out anything that may have an expiration date, and then put it back in and replace new oxygen absorbers, tighten it back down, and of course, you know, you've got to seal those threads to keep it watertight. Then I'll place that back in. And then it's a matter of replacing some of the dirt back in here, keeping in mind that I've now taken up a lot of that space with the actual cache itself. So what I'll do is pack some dirt in here and understand that, all right, gotta find this. You wanna put more dirt in here than you think you need because you're putting it in loosely. Even if you pack it down, it's still gonna settle as it rains. And what you don't wanna do is not put enough in here and it settles down and you have this depression showing right where you dug this cache in. So that's not what you wanna do. I'm gonna take some dirt and start replacing it, understanding that it's not gonna take all of that. I'm gonna put that in, pack it down a little bit. Maybe a little more on this end. And I've left a little bit of space here because the grass plug still has a lot of soil intact where the roots are. And I'm gonna put this in, and basically as I'm placing it in there, as I need to, if I need to add more dirt or take dirt away to keep that somewhat level, if not level, just a little bit high of level so that it can settle, then that's what I'm gonna do. And it's just a matter of taking the plugs. The grass on these plugs are still alive. So it's gonna go back to normal pretty quickly. Now all I have to do is take the dirt and kind of fill in the seams here. Once I've got this filled in around the seams, what I want to do is make it look as natural as possible. So I'll come through and kind of fluff the grass and spread the dirt a little. And because this plug was taken out as a whole, it's all going to start growing back together. And it's going to keep it from looking too out of place. It won't be long before this is all grown back over and it'll be almost indistinguishable from the rest of the environment. And my goal, again, is to not create a lot of displacement, and I want it to go back to natural as soon as possible. So this is just slightly higher than the rest of it, so that's enough material in here that so that when it settles, it should be right level with the ground. That looks pretty good. You're gonna take the excess dirt that you didn't put back in the hole, and this is another reason why I always put it on a poncho, because you're gonna have so much leftover dirt. You don't want that just sitting up here around your cache, because it's obvious that somebody dug something in here. You want to take this dirt, roll it up in the poncho towards the center. Then I can use that poncho to take this excess dirt and spread it out throughout the area. You know, no big piles of anything are left anywhere, and it's going to be a lot less noticeable. So that is how I in place the cache. And as far as servicing, same thing. Bring a poncho, bring a shovel, recover it, change out what you need to, look for expiration dates, change out the oxygen absorbers, the desiccant packets, and look for corrosion on anything that's corrodible inside those. So that's how I in place them. And of course, your goal is to have this look like nobody was ever here as quickly as possible.